Just to make absolutely sure I don't get sued, I'm going to begin this one particular video with a disclaimer that I don't own the characters that are depicted in the following video. The rights to them go to not only author Anne Rice, but to the characters' copyright holders, whoever they may be. And hello there everyone, and welcome to my channel. That was weird. That thing I did with my voice there. I saw a comment once that was like, oh yeah, all Sims YouTubers have the same voice. It's, yeah, we do. It's fucking true, we all have the same voice. Anyway, so this is just a fun little video that I made. I thought I'm not going to commentate the whole thing because that would be boring and you'll all be sick of the sound of my voice. So hooray! Luckily for you lot, I'm not going to commentate this whole thing. I was just sort of going to introduce it. So here, the first in a hopefully quite a long series of what I would like to call Cass Adventures. So adventures in Creator Sim. And here I am creating my personal interpretation of the characters Lestat. I'm about to butcher a French accent. De Leoncourt and Louis Dupont-du-Lac. I don't know. A load of French people are probably going to kill me. Very, very sorry for butchering the accent there. Anyway, from the Vampire Chronicles, or this was kind of how I pictured them when I first read Interview with the Vampire about a year ago. I've only read the first three books, but I'm absolutely obsessed with them. I love those books so much. Of course, I watched the film and I was like, they don't look anything like how I pictured them. But, you know, this is my interpretation of how they looked anyway. Very luckily for me, as you could see just at the beginning there, it initially gave me the sim that I made again, about a year ago, of Peter Murphy from Bauhaus. I made a sim of him a little while ago, and it gave me that. And funnily enough, I pictured Lestat as looking kind of like a slightly more blonde, slightly paler, slightly even more vampiric Peter Murphy. So that was really, really lucky. So I didn't have to do that much to change Lestat's face. I just kind of made his mouth a bit bigger and changed his eyes a little bit. Kind of because he's described in The Vampire Lestat as having a mouth that's quite oversized. This is going to be a kind of modern interpretation of the way they look. With Lestat, I went with kind of a more classic look. And then with Louis, I didn't know what to make him wear, so I just sort of made him wear quite modern clothes. So yes, it's a modern kind of interpretation of how they'd look. If any of you want, I might make kind of a later on, I might make a Let's Play series with these sims, but yeah, I might get sued by Anne Rice. The thing about that was, I was reading about it on the internet, it's of course, people are like, why do you need disclaimers for fanfiction? It's because Anne Rice sued a load of people for writing Vampire Chronicles fanfiction. That's why. That's the main reason that I put a disclaimer on the video. I know she doesn't really like people using her characters, but this video is literally just a bit of fun, and I'm in no way claiming these characters as my own, as much as they are characters that I love very, very much. I do not love them as much as my original characters, though. I do not love them as dearly as I love Dorian and Alex and Frankie and all my original characters, who you will probably meet if you have not already met them. quite soon on this channel. I'd love to, you know, just thank everybody for the overwhelming positivity on my recent videos, even though they've been unlisted. So I don't even know how you had access to them. Really, it's truly, truly astounding. So now I've introduced the video, I'm going to shut up now and let you observe these beautiful Sims that I am creating. So goodbye.
Like an innocent lamb, how I can never show my face at noon. And you'll only see me walking by the light of the moon. The brim of my hat hides the eye of a beast, of the face of a sinner. But the hands of a priest, oh, you'll never see my shade or hear the sound of my feet while there's a moon over Bourbon. I must love what I destroy and destroy the thing I love.